So today we have a very special Murli, and this Murli is having a title, the basis of claiming a number in the rosary of victory. The Murli is dated 16th of November 1981. So rosary of victory, Vijay Mala. Everyone has a thought, you know, that may I come in the rosary of victory? And if yes, what would be the requisites of it? So whenever a person is studying or doing any task which has a goal, there is often a benchmark set for that person so that that person gets motivated to perform more. The person is motivated to give his best. May that be in the school while we were studying, in the college, or even for that matter, our workplaces. There is, during the year, and there is a evaluation system. Each employee also does his own evaluation. The manager also evaluates. Each organization have their own criteria for rating. And based on the performances, both the employee and employer evaluates, and sometimes the ratings or the increments are also based on those evaluations. And sometimes it is taken just like a cutthroat competition and in a negative sense. But if we really take that as a positive sense, that this is something which will help us to grow, help us to identify the areas of improvement, or help us to celebrate the areas of our success. So this will motivate person to perform something more, do something better. Had there been no evaluation system, school, college, or anywhere for that matter, there would be no reason or no motivation for anyone to go ahead. So likewise, we probably even have that in our Brahman culture. And that is why Baba keeps on referring to the rosary of victory, maybe in the Sakar Murli or maybe in the Avyakt Murli. So that, of course, we have got Baba, we are his children, we have this knowledge, that's a great thing. That is something which Baba always mentions. Even having the knowledge of Baba will make someone elevated, at least to claim a seat in the paradise, in the kingdom. But what next? And that is where Baba then gives us the idea that what we should do so that we get into the kingdom, we claim a better position. And this is something which helps us keep on moving ahead, keep on identifying our core areas of improvement. And many of you all must also be knowing that these days in Yagya, there is another contest called as Praburatna. Of course, that is not a contest for the rosary, but that is something to do with how we can develop our skill sets and, you know, showcase them to the Yagya, to the world. This is that they have planned to declare first three. So we did an orientation session in one of the buffer days in the India Vek Murli Club. I'm not sure of here, but in case if anybody is really interested to know something more, let me know, Rakhi Ben know, so that we can help you with identifying. There are around 16 categories where this competition is there, of which I think one category is closed on 15th. of October and others category, we still have time until 30th November. So you all can do submissions. Anyways, coming back to the Murli, I think we have to start. So let us understand, probably since this Murli is entirely dedicated towards basis of claiming a number in the Rosary of Victory, let's see what Baba has to say about it. And just for your information, actually, when I came into this godly knowledge way back in 2003, and after a couple of years, I did understand that there is something called as Rosary of Victory. And that time I was not introduced to all the Avyakta Muralis. Of course, I knew that there were Avyakta Muralis, but I didn't have that patience, and we didn't have technology to search which Murali is speaking what, because those days were not, a computer where we had all the Muralis on the website or someplace. All these Muralis were only in the hard copy stage, at least as far as I am aware of. So I do remember I had dropped an email to Dadi Janki ji. I was apparently searching that email last night when I had an understanding that I have to read this Murli, but I couldn't find that email. But I will definitely have stored that somewhere. Need to check. And I had mentioned in that email, I remember that Dadiji, what is the basis of coming into the victory? What exactly you are doing? And Dadiji gave a very wonderful reply. First thing, I was probably not expecting Dadiji to respond me, because it was not that, Dadiji didn't know me that way personally. But there was one very senior sister in Pune, and she told me that, because she was very close to Dadi Janki, and she told that, "Praful, I send at least one email every month to her, and she gives me a reply, even if that is for a sentence or so, where Dadiji gives reply to all the emails." Because Dadiji followed that trend of Brahma Baba responding to all the email, all the physical posts on those days. So I thought, maybe let me also drop an email. Let's see what Dadiji, if Dadiji really responds to it. And so I thought, what should I ask? So I asked about this, "Dadiji, how can I come into the victory?" And I remember when I joined office, I think it was late in 2009 or 10, somewhere I had sent her an email. And I had taken a printout of that email and put it on my notice board at the cubicle where I work in office for many days, just to remind me that these are the points which Dadiji mentioned. So I'll do share that in the group later on once I get that email. It's very interesting that Dadiji herself replied basis the Murli and basis her churnings. So I just recall that email, and apparently I just forgot that until yesterday when I thought of reading this Murli. So anyways, let me start reading. It's already 10 minutes over. "The basis of claiming a number in the Rosary of Victory. Today, Bab Dada has come once again to meet his long lost and now found elevated souls. Do you remember how many times we have met at this time? And in this form? Do you have the experience of the awareness of having had this meeting many times clearly?" So, as usual, Baba is asking us questions just to check whether our intellect is really grooved for listening the Murli. So he's recalling that the knowledge of 5,000 years, and he asks us, "Do you remember how many times we have met this and in this form?" So even today we are connected over a Zoom call. Probably so many times we would have been connected. Not only this year, this birth, but from so many kalps. Do you have the experience of the awareness of having had this meeting many times clearly? Do you understand or experience this on the basis of knowledge and in terms of the cycle? The more clearly you experience this, the more elevated and close a soul you are. On the basis of this, you will experience all attainments at present, and you will also be a soul who has the right to an elevated reward in the future. On the basis of this experience, you can also understand what number you, the soul, will claim in the rosary of victory. Bab Dada also remembers you children number wise on the basis of your present efforts and attainment. So, do you know your number both in this rosary and also in the rosary of your memorial, which is also known as the rosary of victory? Do you know your own number yourself? Or would you say that Bab Dada should tell you your number? Bab Dada knows it. Anyway, but you also know yourself. Whether you put it into words or not, you definitely do know it internally. Do you not? So let us take a pause and just check for ourselves that do we know which is our number, the rosary? Because Baba is asking us to do that. Let me repeat this statement again. So do you know your number both in the rosary both in this rosary and also in the rosary of your memorial, which is known as the rosary of victory? Are you saying yes or no? If Baba were to make you create a rosary, would you not be able to give yourself a number? If there is hesitation in doing this, that is a different matter. But what would be said if you don't actually know it? You challenge others with a great faith and intoxication that you know the life story of your 84 births. You do all say this, do you not? Therefore, out of your 84 births, this present birth of yours is the most elevated, is it not? Are you not able to know yourself in this birth? Who am I? You know the answer to this riddle very well, do you not? So, what is this? This too is the riddle of who am I? It is very easy to know this account. So, like, just as we know that we all are souls, similarly, what is my part in this 84 births? What position would I be claiming in the rosary? That is also something which we should be aware of, and that is an extension to who am I. So let me just read this statement again. Are you not able to know yourself in this birth? Who am I? You know the answer to this riddle very well, do you not? So what is this? This too is the riddle of who am I. It is very easy to know this account. So now Baba is helping us understand where are we sitting in the rosary. So let's try to focus what Baba has to say. One rosary is that of remembrance. The more love you have in remembrance of the Father, and the more time you spend in that remembrance, the Father accordingly remembers you for just as long and with just as much love. Let me read again. The more love you have in remembrance of the Father, and the more time you spend in that remembrance. There are two aspects. The time we spend in that remembrance and the quantum of love. Okay? And the reciprocation is again the two. The Father accordingly remembers you for just as long. That is the time aspect, and with just as much love, the quantum of love. Therefore, are you able to give yourself a number? Just consider this. If you only remember the Father for half the time you should, with only 50 or 75% love, then on the basis of that, you would only enter the rosary when it is half completed. That is when half the time has passed. So Baba is asking us to assess basis how much percentage and how much percent love do we have, Baba? This is that we can understand which portion of the rosary we would be sitting. So let me read this again. Just consider this. If you only remember the Father for half the time you should, when with only 50 or 75% love, then on the basis of that, you would only enter the rosary when it is half completed. That is, when half of the time has passed. However, if your remembrance is constant and your love is total, if you don't look at anyone but the one Father, and you remain constantly combined with the Father, then you would come into the rosary as combined beads. That is, you would be connected to the Father. You would constantly be number one in every aspect. You would be number one in the rosary. So, but this is the crux of the Murli. Let me read this again. Let us understand what Baba has to say. If your remembrance is constant and your love is total, so both time aspect, the constant, and the aspect of the quantum of love, which is total, if you don't look at anyone but the one Father, so that is again expanding the second part. What is the meaning of total love, which Baba mentioned above? If you don't look at anyone but the one Father, and the first aspect, which Baba tells your remembrance is constant, he expands that, and you remain constantly combined with the Father, then you would come into the rosary as combined basis. That is, you would be connected to the Father. You would constantly be number one in every aspect. You would be number one in the rosary too. Just as there is the first division, second and third division in your worldly education, so here too, you have the three divisions of elephant, riders, cavalry, and infantry. Maharathi, Ghodeswar, Pyade. So Baba is now telling us the gradation, which division, what exactly will be the characteristics, features. First number he has already mentioned, now the divisions. The first division will always be fast. That is, they are always in the flying stage. They experience the father's company, cooperation and love in every thought they have and in every and at every second. They constantly experience being hand in hand with the father and in the father's company. They never ask for anything such as give me cooperation. They always experience themselves to be full. Wonderful. So Baba is just giving us, let us read it again. The first division will always be first. That is, they are always in the flying stage. They experience the father's company, cooperation, and love in every thought they have and at every second. They constantly experience being hand in hand with the father and in the father's company. They never ask for anything such as give me cooperation. They always experience themselves to be full. Now, the second division, experience the ascending stage, but not the flying stage. चढ़ती कला अनुभव करते हैं, उड़ती कला नहीं. Sometimes it takes less time and sometimes it takes more time to overcome the obstacles that come in the ascending stage. Those in the flying stage go above all obstacles to cross them. They feel that no obstacle even can, sorry, they feel that no obstacle even come to them. They don't consider obstacles to be obstacles, but only sightseers. Scenes along the way. When those whose stage is ascending feel that something is an obstacle, they stop. This is why they sometimes have a sight feeling of tiredness and get disheartened while overcoming obstacles. So the third division, you must know them by now. To move along, to stop, and to cry out. Sometimes they move along and sometimes they cry out. They are engaged in making effort to have remembrance because they are not always combined. They are constantly trying to fulfill their responsibility of all relationships. They are constantly engaged in making effort. Such souls are constantly trying to achieve this attainment, whereas those souls constantly have this attainment. So, you can all understand from this what your number is. Do you come in the beginning of the rosary, which means the first division, in the middle of the rosary, which means second division, or at the end of the rosary, which is the third division? Therefore, on the basis of both your remembrance and your victory, You can know yourself. Is it difficult or easy to know this? Shall we try and find out everyone's number? You will be able to do it, will you not? So let us pause here. There is second part of this Murli, but let us read that on Monday. I'm pausing for a minute. Let's try to reflect what this Murli brings to us, and then we can start sharing. Okay, maybe we can start sharing now.
Shanti. Thank you, Baba. Thank you, Divine Family. And this is a rosary of victory. And Baba's give my takeaway point of that's a faith and another is remembrance. And one connection with one. And the constantly. Constantly remembrance and faith. So this is the main pillar of division. In what division we are. So that gave us the number. Om Shanti. Thank you, Baba.
Okay, wonderful. So when Baba says, the more time you spend in the remembrance, the Father accordingly remembers you for just as long and with just as much love. So it's like very much reciprocal. So I've experienced this, like some days we are in a very good mood. And right from Amrit Vela, it's like we are on top of the world and we keep on having a gratitude towards Father Baba, wonderful. Whatever you get, you are so pleased. And maybe that with that intoxication, even Baba would be reciprocating similar things. Because Baba told that as long as it you love or you remember me, you know, he even does the same. And at certain point of time, we can even feel that experience. We can feel that bliss coming from him. And that makes us, at least that makes me so much joyful that probably Baba is responding. It is not that I'm thanking, but there is something which I'm getting in return.
Yeah, number
So,
wise.
sorry.
Yeah, getting in number wise.
Yeah, but maybe at that time I don't feel that Baba is remembering me lesser or more. As long as I feel that I am getting that connection from Baba or some joy, that makes me makes me very much happy. Of course, as you mentioned, there would be many who would be constantly remembering Baba throughout the day. They may be getting that much more love and affection. And you
Yes.
know, that is the beauty at the place where Baba is staying, that at one time he can cater to so many people. Probably here in the physical world, at a time we can probably remember only one person or do only one task because of the limitation of our body, or maybe even for that matter, intellect. We don't really do multitasking. We can just do one thinking at a time. But Baba, many times he says that on his TV screen, he can see as many souls he wants, and he can give similar sustenance to so many souls. So that is very much interesting, which he has a fifth dimension, which you're not aware of much. No, there was something. One very interesting message of Bhog when this person Jagdish Bhai left body. So he always had that thought that how would Baba meet or do so much service throughout in the world at the Avyakt Vatan? Because in the physical form, it's a physical body, it's not really possible. And he always had that question. And once he left the body, then I think Baba made him experience that the 12 days. That's what it was mentioned in that Sandesh. And he himself gave an experience, rather, he shared his experience to Dadi that even at the while his final rites were done, he could actually see at the same time what was going into the hearts of so many people about him. Baba made him visit different centers, each center what is happening, and everything could be parallelly done. So that was quite interesting to know. So yeah, so I think of course we might not be able to do that at this moment of time because Baba has just told us to remember him. But sometimes when I think of how Baba reciprocates, because each one feels that Baba is mine. And the same kind of experience they get from Baba. And there will be lakhs of souls who are remembering Baba. They experience the same thing. So sometimes I really wonder how Baba functions. But yeah, as Baba mentioned, he would definitely be doing that. And we all might have experienced that in some way or other. Om Shanti.
So wonderful. Baba says if your remembrance is constant and your love is top delivering, you don't look at anyone but just one father, and you will remain constantly connected. And if you look at all three, right, all three divisions, in the first division, they are going at very fast. They have that flying stage and they don't really
They never ask for cooperation. They are not expecting anything from Baba. So they experience everything to be full. They themselves are full. And the second division is some. They don't experience the flying stage, but still they experience that ascending stage. And the third stage, again, they are just making effort to just stay in Baba's remembrance. So, this number, na, so I was thinking, why this number? Because I think it's based on the faith that they have, right, in Baba and what Baba says, right? So when we remember Baba, yeah, we all experience Baba's company and the power. But the number comes when what Baba says, right, any statement that Baba gives, right, so how much percentage faith I have in what Baba says to me? Do I completely believe that and experience what he says? Right, I think that's where this all comes, right? Any thoughts on that, brother?
Yes. And as you were mentioning, brother, I just flashed that screen again, the first division. And definitely faith is the basis. I would just like to drive everyone's attention to the last four lines. What you all see in the first paragraph. Where Baba explicitly says that they never ask for anything such as give me cooperation. They always experience themselves to be full. So, you know, the one implication of these two statements is that first thing is, I think, quite clear. They will never ask, and we all understand in many Murlis Baba mentioned this, ki mangenge nahi, they are adhikari and all those things. But the second statement, they always experience themselves to be full. So, what I was reflecting is that these souls, you know, the first division souls, they might not think that in future at such and such thing I will attain such and such thing, or I will get victory at some point of time in future, or I'm attaining so and so qualities, or I'm making effort to become so and so. Nothing futuristic. They are experiencing themselves as full at all times. In other words, they are living in present. Many times it so happens, even in Laukik, when we plan to gain some rank or some position, or maybe even as I was sharing at the beginning, in a company where we strive hard to get a good rating towards the end, or increment, or whatever, there is always a futuristic tag assigned that if I do this, I will get so and so thing. But the person who are in the first division, probably, they are always into that super senses joy of having that already attained, or they consider themselves as full. And that is why, Baba is not telling this statement that they never ask for anything. This is not for Baba and not for anyone, other souls, or even not probably for them, that I need to be more cooperative. Probably they are always into that stage. So that also is a very important factor which makes them come into the first division. Although the second division also are in the accelerating stage, ascending stage. They are also growing. But again, since they are experiencing the growth, or they have this thing, they are still in the second stage because they have not attained that. So yeah, that was one reflection from my side. Om Shanti.
So we can't really blame Baba here, because the kind of Murli and the kind of teaching that he gives is it's the same for everyone. But I think it's the faith that children has, or can we blame the drama for this? Because the number has to be created, right? Because Baba is creating a kingdom here.
Right. Yeah, for the sake of blaming, definitely we can catch hold of Rama, because even Baba does that sometimes in Sakar Murli. Sometimes he asks, "Bachche, aap itne gire kyu ho?" And he has faith in faithfulness. "Bachche, aap to nahi girte the." But it's probably because of Maya, Ravan, or it was destined in the drama. That's why you came down. So Baba has a faith in us that we ourselves, once he prepared us, you know, the kings and queens of the entire world, we wouldn't have really come down. He probably has the faith even in his products, that he teaching and we coming down, it is not possible. But you know, there is someone to blame. So yeah, drama, Maya, Ravan. So very interesting. Of course, we do that because of our own these things. But yeah, sometimes Baba makes the conversation quite interesting.
Praful Bhai, Om Shanti. Om Shanti.
Yes, I can hear you. Tell me.
See, Baba, when he speaks here about the rosary, I thought it was all only on the basis of remembrance. Because even before he speaks about the various divisions, there was this, just one sentence, a few lines which really hits you. Like, if your remembrance is constant, if your love is total, if you don't look at anyone but the one Father. So these three things, constant love, constant remembrance, total love, or if A, looking only at anyone but the one Father, then we are combined with the Father, then we would come into the rosary as combined beads. So that one part I couldn't understand about the division, that we would be combined beads and we would be connected to the Father, we would be number one in every aspect. So there Baba speaks about number one as combined. Then he explains about the first division, second division, third division, and all, like as they give us even in school education and all. So I just was trying to throw some light on both these differences. What is this being connected to the Father, that is in the rosary also being connected to the Father? Because as long as I know, it's only down, they say, no, the dual bead, Mama and Baba, they are the only ones who are closely connected to the Father. Then that's what even I took that to be. Then Baba speaks about these three divisions. Is there any difference in that paragraph based on this? Just that Yad ki rosary, if you can see. Because he says you would be number one in the rosary too, like first division, second division. Then, of course, he gives the three division, which he always says as Maharati, Cavalry, and all. Can you, just that paragraph, if you could a little bit clarify?
Yeah, so I think you have already answered that in the question itself, and even I have the same understanding that so in the physical rosary, if you see, there is this a flower at the beginning to which two beads are attached, combined, and then the rosary starts, the beads one after another. So Baba also defined the Merudana, the Brahma Baba and maybe Mama, as we understand, they are connected to that flower. They are connected to Baba in a combined thing. So that Merudanas, those three things basically, two beads and the flower or whatever you call, maybe that's a bunch of threads which is at the beginning, which you know everyone puts to their eyes when they start rotating the rosary. So all these three are very much combined. And probably that is number one, which Baba mentioned. And the benchmark is so high that constantly one, we can't remember. There is no one other than Baba. And probably that is the kind of purushart which Brahma Baba and Mama might have done. And that is the reason for them to claim that number one position. And then after that comes the three divisions. First division, second division, third division. So first, as we all understand, it's 108, 808, and then 16,000 and whatever. The total count has not mentioned in today's Murli, but sometimes he mentions in different Murlis. And then so first is one very special category. And of course, not everybody would be able to come first. But he has still defined, because we all wanted that understanding of why did Brahma Baba even claim that number one in the rosary? What has made him claim? So he has defined exactly what does number one mean. And then comes the first division and whatever, as you mentioned in the three paragraphs Baba has mentioned, how this classification is being done. Anyone has any other thoughts?
So it is the three tier you're saying, right? It is not, I always used to think the rosary to be, a straight line, bolte na, the rosary which goes from the beginning to end, from this, because Baba also mentions, if you see, even the last bead of the rosary is very dear to me as the first one. It's not that I have a different kind. So now, according to this Murli, it looks like, kya bolte na, three tiers. Tire number one, tire number two, tire number three. So
if you see, even in Vishnu's neck, there are different rosaries. One rosary is small, which just comes to the neck. Other rosary is big, which may come to the chest, something. Some also comes until the, So just to give a reference, I'm mentioning this. So these rosary. And so the first bead and the last bead. Okay, so last bead means, again, it's in a circular fashion. So both of them basically are closer to the first two Merudana. So they claim very much close. And the bead which is the furthest, that is in the middle basically of the rosary, technically speaking. So that bead would be then, in that specific rosary, would be the person who is not claiming very close role towards the first, second, or whatever third you call it. But like that, there are different rosaries. So first grade has its own rosary, second grade its own rosary, and third is the other rosary. And we have this even in the Bhakti Mark today. Like I generally go to this, I had been going, not now, but like 20 years or 15 years back, there is a temple called a Sala Sarji in Rajasthan. So they practically have this 16,000 ka rosary, and it's a huge thing. It's a huge thing. Like we can't, it takes hours to, do that beads. So that remembrance is even in the Bhakti Marg as of now. So each rosary, each gradation is different. To answer you in short.
It's very nice. I think you should share with us that. I remember Vishnu Mala. I'm not sure of it. But I like that other rosary. I think I would like to know, because this rosary subject, let me share with you. Sometimes it's a little complicated for me. Sometimes Baba speaks about Rund Mala, Vijay Mala, Vishnu Mala. So many malas he speaks about. In every Murli, he changes the subject. Today he has given the qualification, because he's asking in the question, where are you? He asks, where are you? So that's why probably he has given this three division for me to know. Then I should not tell him, why Baba, you have not put me in the third. Merudana, I think nobody is going. First Lakshmi, first Narayan. But I always used to think the second Lakshmi and second Narayan, they are not Merudana, but then the first division comes here. Just to understand, if really you see, this is just a knowledge. But I think for me, a rosary or anything. But I just wanted to understand, as you said, the bhakti and what Baba and so many other malas. Okay. We should have a separate Murli, I think, only on this malas.
We need to search, maybe. And interestingly, even if you see, na, Baba sometimes gives this reference of eat. So eat, there is no mala as such. There is this, what you called it, a ring. Aat ratano ki mala. Aat ratano ka, what you call it, anguthi or something. Actually, the rosary is of 108 only. So even in 108, the top 8 is one category, which Baba sometimes mentions, Ashta Ratan. So they are not called as rosary, but Ratan. Then comes the first division of 8, and then whatever, 108, and then the others, 16,000 and whatever, no luck. Anyways, so...
Prasad Bhai, but isn't this Ashta Ratan, Baba says they'll always be with Dharmaraj? When we are going to enter that immigration point, these 8 people will be there. I remember in one Murli Baba
yes.
said these 8 people will be there. So I often used to think, like, you know, like asking recommendations from the dadis and all. I used to think, oh my God, no, these Ashta, but they won't recognize us there. When they are standing with Dharmaraj, nobody would know even that you have come there. Because I remember asking Nirvair Bhai this question. He was the one who said, 8 people will be standing there with Dharmaraj.
So think of it like this. So for example, if you are a school teacher, okay, and in school, you in your class specifically, you might know the kids who are good, who are scholars, who are not too good. But at the prize distribution day, when you're standing with the principal, and when your class students and even other class students are coming to take the prize, that time you will just smile, or that time you will not say much or anything to that kid. You will just become a sakshi and just give away the award which the principal is giving. Maybe at the back of the mind, you must be knowing, oh good, this student has come here, he was capable or whatever. But that is not the time to talk to that person, because that is this ceremony going on. So even if Dadi might know you, because now, or anybody for that matter, but there is no point in doing that, because anyways, the awards are declared. So that time you will not tell on the stage, why are you third? You could have fitted a little more. You could have come first. And even the person receiving award may not have that thing to talk to you. It just, he comes, takes the award, he goes off. And you as a Sakshi Drishta just sees, maybe at the most you can smile, nothing more that we can do. So probably even those 8 ratans in the vatan, they must be just a silent spectator, observers, Baba. And, you know, of course, they won't always be punishing us or something as such. But I don't know how things would be. Even I didn't experience that. Maybe if I would have experienced, I might have forgotten after 5,000 years. But I was just visualizing, you know, nothing much there will be for us to talk to them or they talking to us, because everything will be known to us by then. What we have done, whether we have done good or whatever we have done bad. And there is no other option for us but just to accept whatever things are. Because even in the physical customs, if you see, the declaration is given us, that form is given before the immigration, you know. Whatever is there, just tell us beforehand. But if you don't do that, somehow we get caught or whatever happens, then, you know, like nothing can be done much.
Interesting, very interesting.
Anyway, so let us pause. And okay, just to remind everybody that today we have this meeting celebration at in the evening at Madhuban. So it's good that we try to stay in Mon throughout the day as much as we can, and try experiencing Bhaptada Milan in the evening. So tomorrow we will be reading that Murli, whatever is read or replayed today in Diamond Hall. And we'll continue with this Murli maybe on Monday. The main aspect of the Murli is already over, but yeah, something more on this churning. Because it's interesting at least to know, you know, the institution, the greatest of greatest exam, which we are all giving in some way or another. It is good to churn on how things would be evaluated. And it's worth spending some time with this. So we'll continue this discussion maybe on Monday after reading the second part. So let's pause for a minute and give our gratitude towards Baba for making everything so clear to us. We go to the Vatan, take beautiful drishti from Bap Dada. And as we give our gratitude, we come back down on our throne. I am the ruler of this chariot, and my chariot is ready for another beautiful day. Om Shanti. Okay, thank you everyone. Have a great day with Baba. Meet you all again. Om Shanti.